The President. Members, at the meeting yesterday, Mr. Ted Ho turned on a beeping device or a sounding device, and the device was placed at the ventilation valve of his seat. I once again warned Mr. Ted Ho not to turn on any sound generating devices which would affect the operation of the meeting, or else I would deem it as grossly disorderly conduct, and I would dismiss Mr. Ted Ho as a result of the rules of procedure. Any member who commits such acts of nuisance would be asked to leave the chamber immediately. Mr. Ken Leung, call for quorum under Rule 17 brackets 2 of the ROP. Please, members, please switch your phones to silent mode.
梁繼昌議員。
Mr. Kenneth Lang. As we scrutinize whether we should resume the second reading debate on the bill, the key is to assess whether the bill complies with the spirit of rule of law. In the past year or two, the loyalists have been saying that rule of law is about enforcing laws and the public should comply with the laws, and this is rule of law. President, however, this is just one part of the spirit of rule of law. In terms of the National Anthem Bill, if we are to assess whether it fulfills the spirit of rule of law, we must look at the legislative intent, the legislative outcome, as well as proportionality. Before I go into details of the bill, I'd like to talk about the reasons that dictate whether our society has rule of law. You might have heard the differences between rule of law and rule by law. Apart from the social impacts of a bill, an independent judiciary, and everyone is equal before the law, and whether the public can easily or reasonably secure legal support. These are all cornerstones of rule of law. In terms of the legislative intent of the National Anthem Bill, what is it at the end of the day? It promotes respect towards the national anthem. But what is meant by respect? Respect is an idea. Can one legislate to promote respect for a person? And there is a saying in Cantonese that you are the only person who can give yourself respect. Should respect be imposed upon someone, or should it be voluntary? If you go to a concert and people would naturally remain silent, so likewise, when you hear any national anthem, you would remain silent and rise. Ms. Eddie Xu, please leave the chamber immediately. I have said yesterday, you cannot put up derogatory signs. Ms. Eddie Xu, please leave the chamber. How is this insulting? Andrew Lang, why is this insulting? Please look at the sign carefully. What is the justification, Andrew Lang? Did you read such words? How did I insult anyone or Starry Lee? How could you expel me? You can ask for a clarification if you can't read these words clearly, and I won't blame you for that.
朱凱迪議員
Mr. Eddie Chu, please leave the chamber.
會議現在暫停。
The meeting is now suspended.